Okay, I think this video is gonna get the most hits. Okay, I'm gonna share some of the, I wouldn't say debugging the myth, but I'm gonna share some very crucial points. I think a lot of people have been seeing a lot of advertisement on Instagram, on Facebook, and they see this thing like leveraging sell one HDB buy two condo, or sell your HDB buy condo without using your savings. Okay, so is this possible or not? I want to share with this is that there's no secret lah. Meaning that there's no loopholes to all these things. It really depends on you. You know, your income, how much loan can you borrow, how much money do you take back from your selling, what is your current property price like. It's really like primary school mathematics or secondary school mathematics. We call it a problem sum. Okay, so it's more of a problem sum. So for example, you see, first of all, what we do is we have to first calculate, if you sell your place, how much do you take back? Secondly, we have to understand how much loan can you borrow if you sell your place. Okay? Thirdly, with these two amount add together, can you afford a private property? Okay, why a lot of agents are sharing this like buy two, sell one, buy two, that kind of thing, you know? The reason is because, right, a lot of Singaporeans are sitting on their HDB flat, you know, fully paid, if not bought at a very low price, appreciate many times, then appreciate so many times but drop many times because they didn't sell when it was appreciating at the highest point. Many people are sitting on this kind of properties, and this kind of properties, right, is like depreciating property now, meaning that because they're lucky, they bought many years ago, so it has appreciated to like very sky up, but now every year it starts to drop because of old age, aging, because the property is aging. But they don't realize that. But you see, if these people have sold it off and like take the money, then check out how much loan they can take, then add together and see whether they can get a private property. I think the main most difficult and most problematic point is, are you willing to pay the higher installment? Because you see, this is always not being shared, like in a lot of advertisement, you know, in a way is that yeah you do this, do that, but your installment may be higher, you know, but your installment also may not be higher, because for HDB, right, we only have like loan tenure max 25. So today, for a 35 years old to buy HDB, the loan tenure max is 25 years. But when he buy private property, he gets to go up to 30 years. So with the extension of loan tenure, the installment may also drop. And so this is also subjective, you see. Subjective in a way whereby it's back to problem sums. It's back to mathematics. So a good agent will be able to count. A good agent will be able to count for you and help you understand that. And there's no tricks to this, you know, so you can't get cheated over this, okay? Because when you count, you will know whether you can or you cannot, okay? So it's very simple. And the idea of selling one HDB to buy two condo is also possible, right? Because let's say husband and wife is working. Then you sell away the HDB flat. The husband buy one, the wife buy one. Can ma? Correct. So all these things is not say cannot. It's still back to the sums. And this kind of sums work very well, right, for people that is staying in high value HDB. And they are still at the young middle age kind of way. And the career is still ongoing. Very good income status. Very good income amount. If you calculate like people at Bishan, people at Duxton, people at Pinnacle, people at like EAEMs, executive apartments, executive mansionaries, people at really big DBSS flats like 5 room, It's possible, you know, if we do the sum, it's possible. So there's no hard and fast rule. The only thing that is, I just want to share is that whatever this method, they are healthy, they are good, because a private property will definitely be a better investment than a HDB flat. And if you are able to look into the price chart in the area for your HDB, you will be able to understand, is it healthy to hold the HDB for the next 10 years. Okay, so these are ways that can be done. There's no loopholes. So important thing, again, I'm going to say it again, is the amount of money that going to come back when you sell your place, the amount of loan that you can loan up to. These two things add up together were able to tell you whether you can afford your private property or not, and whether are you affording it alone or are you affording with 2 persons. Because if you afford it alone, right, means that the other person's CPF cannot use. If you afford it like together, that means that both CPF can use. So the difference is actually at the CPF amount plus the income. Because if 2 persons, then they will calculate combined income. If 1 person, they will only calculate 1 person's income. So that's provided, like, let's say both have high income, or one have high income, one have lower income. Then one will buy the 2 or 3 bedroom for own stay, then the other one will buy a 1-bedder for investment. That's what some advertisements are saying, like buy 2, sell 1, buy 2. Okay, so it's still possible. It really depends on how you see it and whether the calculation makes sense or not. Okay, so debugging the myth, it's not a myth lah, you know, it's like, I just want to give you a clearer information. I don't know if people will like kill me for this video. You're like, hey Aaron, why are you sharing our asset progression method? Okay, but again, it's not easy to calculate. Okay, so it's not easy to calculate. So I'm pretty sure that not a lot of you can calculate well. Know how to calculate it correctly. Okay, or able to get the correct numbers. So it's still better to find a professional. And I think calculating is not the most important thing, because the next important thing is the transaction. How to sell and buy and where to stay and everything, okay? So it's like a wholesome package, you know? It's not something that, hey, count, so what? So what if you have the mathematics, you know? What are the plans? What is the strategy? What is the strategy for selling? What is the strategy of buying? What is the strategy for transiting? All these things are things that a good agent will be able to share with you. A good agent will be able to advise you accordingly. Okay, so hit the subscribe button. Hey, this video is good lah, you know, I already shared so much already, so just remember to hit the subscribe button. Okay, thank you for watching, and I see you in the next episode. See you.